Hey everybody, I'm Polo18 here and welcome to an update video. I will go over some things, and if you don't feel like sitting and listening to the video, then you can check the description box and it'll have a short summary of the things that I covered. So, updating. Yeah, so if many of you know, I haven't had a lot of content on my channel lately. The uploads are getting really far apart, and there's a few reasons for this, and I'll try to go into them as quickly as possible without overbearing or rambling on. So the first and main reason is loss of interest. Since I've been doing this for so long, and I only have limited hardware, the availability of games that I can play are minimal. The games that I want to do, I can't do because I don't have the hardware. And I've just lost interest in it. Like Yoshi's Island, I think, was part of this catalyst that started this, because Yoshi's Island was really fun when I started, and then it just got really boring, or not really boring, but really frustrating. And I don't want my channel, I never wanted my channel to be one of those channels where I'm frustrated about a game all the time. Some people like that, some people enjoy that. That's not me. I don't want my channel to be that. The other thing is, aside from the loss of interest, is just wanting to get games done. Now, this goes into the production part of Let's Playing. So for games like Yoshi's Island and stuff like that, where I have a lot of failures because of the platforming difficulty, I'll have to sit and watch all that and trim out what I think I can do, and that kind of thing. But then also, like Fire Emblem, like for you people that have been subscribed for probably the last 3 years, know that I've been playing Fire Emblem literally for the last 4 years. I started with Lin's mode, and then Super Genius was in the finale for that one. And then I played the Eliwood mode as a main story, and then I played Lin's hard mode, and now I'm playing Hector normal mode. And it might have something to do with the repetitiveness of it, but I'm just starting to lose interest in it. Like, it's getting bland, and although I love the characters, it's just something that, like, I feel like, oh, I gotta go through another chapter, I gotta do this, I gotta, you know, voice all these characters, which, don't get me wrong, is really fun. I love voicing the characters, but it's just like, it just starts to drag on and on and on. And that's why I started the Leaf Green Randomizer, because even though I enjoy Pokemon, Pokemon is Pokemon. Pokemon will never change. The purpose for a Pokemon Let's Play is to have fun, or if it's your first time playing, to do a blind run. Like, there have been many blind runs of Pokemon that I enjoy watching because I've been playing for so long, and these people have never played these games before, so it's fun to watch those. But I've decided with this randomizer run that it would actually challenge me, you know, make me have to think and remember, like, okay, like, this Pokemon is these two types instead of the types it's supposed to be, or this move can do this, or these TMs are this, and, you know, the basic outline of the game is the same, but there's so much randomized in it that it's almost like a relearning thing. And in the beginning, it was fun. It was really cool. It was interesting. But now, even though I'm not even like halfway through the game, it's come to the point where it's getting stale. Like, it's like, ugh, another one of these. Or, like, another Ho-Oh. Or another Magikarp. Or, oh, another Nidoran. You know, like, it's just getting really stale. And I don't want to cut out the battles because they are randomized, so it's interesting to watch. But at the same time, it's like, that's more time I have to sit through and try to trudge through this game and all these things. And, you know, so it's just not going well. And that leads into the production aspect of Let's Playing, which for me is actually quite difficult. So the recording process is nearly identical to anybody else's recording process. I use Audacity for my audio. I use Fraps for my video. I have an emulator that I run. I actually have a controller now that I've been using to record with instead of playing on my keyboard. So all of that is fine and dandy. I can do 4, 5, 6, half a dozen videos in like a couple hours, like 2, 3 hours. It's the post-recording, the post-production that kills me. So it's crappy outside, and there's a bunch of other reasons, but I've been having a lot of, like, coughing and, like, hacking fits, you know, having to clear my throat because I don't have enough water and that kind of thing, and I have to sit through and edit all that out, which is fine. It just takes time. So for every half-hour video that I watch, I have to watch or record, I have to watch that back a half an hour and sit through and adjust those audio levels. And I don't know how to do all that in Vegas, and I haven't really invested time into doing it. But I'm sure if I did, I could figure it out and, fix it really fast, and I just haven't done that. The other thing is after editing is rendering. Now, I don't have some fancy desktop computer that runs like a dream and can do all these things. No, I have a laptop from 2009 that I got from a friend that already had used it, and I got it like 2 years ago. And I did a system restore, and I got all my programs on it, and it still takes just as long to render videos. And part of the reason I've been neglecting doing videos is I don't want the same thing to happen to this laptop that might happen to my old laptop, which was that I rendered videos to the extent that my hard drive and my processing system got so worn out that it actually burnt out. I don't know if it physically burnt out or it just digitally wrecked. But I just don't want to beat my computer up like that. And so for a 15-minute video to take nearly 1 hour and 10 minutes, it's just way too long to have my computer just sitting and trying its best to run. So that's the other thing. Another point is with work and getting things done and adulting. So I have a full-time job now. I work 40 hours a week. Some weeks I work 50 to 60 hours. So it's a lot of money coming in, a lot of money coming in. And I could be spending that money to the moon if I wanted to. But I'm saving it because at some point I'm going to want to move out because right now I'm living at my parents. Cliche. But I want to save up enough money that I can start moving out and start getting on my own. And at this point, I just can't be investing so much time into LPing that I can't work, And even though I only work 4 to 5 days a week with 10 to 11-hour days, that leaves me enough time to do my errands and do my laundry and all that other kind of house stuff. But when you work from 5:30 to 6 or 5:30 to 7 and you come home, you're just dead. And like it just stockpiles over the week, and by the time your first day off comes, you just don't want to do anything. So I just literally sit at home, veg, and like read books or try to go and do other stuff during the day, like just to try to calm myself down and decompress and get all this stress from work out of the way. And I just don't want to work on LPs. Another thing that kind of goes hand in hand with that is many of you know I'm actually trying to work on a book. I've been writing a book for the last 2 years. And when everyone asks me how my book is going, I always say, "Oh, it's writer's block." But it's not writer's block. It's I don't have time. Like I don't have time to invest in it. I have, as I say, too many irons in the fire. I have to go to work. I have to come home. I have to make dinner. I have to do these things. I want to sit and relax. I want to read. And I only have so much time to do all these things before I'm just so worn out and mentally drained that I don't want to do anything. And so another reason is I want to convert all the time that I do in LPs into working on my book or just relaxing or going out with friends. Like I didn't ever intend for this to be something that I dedicated so much time to that it's all I did. And I still don't want that to happen. So the real question is, what's going to happen then? Well, as much as I hate to say it, after I finish the three games that I'm doing currently, I will be leaving my channel. I'll leave it active so people can go back and watch the videos, watch the playlists, that kind of thing, feel nostalgic. But after I finish the three games that I'm currently doing, I will no longer be uploading content. So after I finish Fire Emblem Hector Mode, Yoshi's Island, which the sixth world will actually be a stream that I'm going to do, and then I'll upload that stream. And then the entirety of the rest of Leaf Green. So what does this mean for you guys? Well, this means that you guys can have more time away from watching my videos to go and watch other content. And as much as I hate to say that, I would rather have you guys spend less time watching my junk than to go and watch someone else's. There are plenty, plenty of fantastic Let's Players out there that deserve and I guess, you know, just deserve more time to them than should be dedicated to me. Like, they work harder on their stuff, they have better content, and they do more things with what they have, and that's just something that I've never been able to do. But I've tried to make it work. I've really tried to make it work, and over the years, it's just gotten harder and harder and harder to do, and I've just decided that this will be the end. This is going to be finished. I'm not making revenue from it. I don't have a huge following, and it's not really a passion anymore. Like, there are things in life that you start when it's new and fresh and everything like that, and when I first started doing Let's Plays, the community was so small compared to what it is now. Like, in the realm of YouTube, there were probably only 1,000 Let's Players when I first started, and this is way back in, like, 2009 or 10. But now it has literally exploded. Like, and I've talked about this in videos and I've made posts about this before, but the YouTube community for gaming has changed so drastically that part of me doesn't even want to be part of it anymore. Like, a lot of it is so toxic and so mind-grabbing and, oh, I need to have subscribers, I need to make money, I need to do these, I need to do this game because it just came out, and, oh, I need to be crazy, you know, or, oh, I'm not getting enough views, so I'll be more like Markiplier, I'll be more like PewDiePie, I'll be more like Jacksepticeye, I'll be more like Chugga, you know, like, there's so many factions of LPs that it's crazy to think that 8 years ago we weren't even close to this. But as technology has advanced so far, being able to do LPs has gotten easier and easier and easier, and there are more and more and more people out there doing the same thing. And I just feel like that for me, it's time to go. It's kind of like when you're at a shindig and, you know, you're having a fun time, all your friends are there, and then it just starts getting late and conversation starts to dull down, and you're just standing there. You're not talking to anybody. You're not eating. The food's gone. You know, the beverages are all drank up. And you're just kind of hanging around. And you're sitting at the table with your friends. And, you know, they're having a great time. And they're doing what they do. And you're just sitting there. And that's when you think, it's time to go. I need to go. And for me, that's what this community is now. There's so many other people that are doing the same thing. And everybody else is involved. And I'm just sitting here. And it's time to go. And so, as sad as that is, I will make another video when I'm done with my current games. That will go into letting you guys know how thankful I am and that kind of thing. But for now, I just wanted to input my thoughts and let you guys know what's going on and that I'm not dead. So that's the thing that's going on right now. So I apologize for this video being long. Once again, if you stuck through the whole thing just to listen, you guys are great. Otherwise, the description should have got read. And that's it. So I will see you next guy. I'll see you next guy. I'll see you guys next time. Catch you later.